Hi everyone, it's Janis here with a new episode to help you build better daily structure and be in control of your life. Why is it that some people become successful and it almost seems easy for them, while others struggle endlessly? While it might seem that these lucky few have something that we don't, like skills, money, or connections, it actually comes down to our resilience. Today, we'll take a look at the book called Resilience to learn how to face rejection and criticism on the road to success. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos about time management and productivity. Also, check out my free productivity resources that has helped thousands of people to set better goals, make better decisions, and build solid structure in their life. Resilience is ability to withstand adversity and bounce back from difficult life events, and it is important because it gives people the strength needed to process and overcome hardship. Your road to success will be full of obstacles and challenges, so you have to be prepared and ready for them. So let's take a look at some of the best strategies that you can use to develop resilience and achieve goals in your life. Number 1, get outside your comfort zone. Many people work hard and still struggle to achieve the results that they desire, and the reason for that is because they are staying inside their comfort zone. If you want to grow and move forward, then you have to be willing to try out new tools and strategies. For sure, managing your team with spreadsheets is cheap and it can work for small teams, but if you want to scale up, then you should consider getting a project management software. You might be used to get clients through Facebook ads, but why not to start investing in content marketing? Of course, it's uncomfortable to do the things that you haven't done before, but that is also where the growth lies. Number 2, pick the right direction. When you start your journey, there are a few important things to consider, and one of these things is to pick the right direction. We face multiple big decisions in our life, and these decisions have a huge influence on our chances to succeed. This might be choosing your education. You might have the option to choose between being an accountant or project manager. Or later in life, you have to choose your career path. You can get a sales representative job and start earning instantly, or pursue your passion for writing. And while writing is not something that will give you quick reward, it's likely that you'll be more persistent in face of the obstacles. So if you want to achieve your goals, then make sure that your goals are something that you're passionate about. Number 3, learn from mistakes. There is no way to avoid mistakes in your life, but that's okay because you can learn a lot from them. Many people make mistakes and then get upset and disencouraged, but mistakes are the part of the journey to success. Of course, it feels bad when you have put in weeks of work in your new sales funnel and in the end it doesn't generate the results that you want. But don't just leave it there, go back and try to understand why it didn't work. Was it a technical issue or the main selling point wasn't good enough? Success is often built on previously failed attempts. If you learn something from every failure that you make, then you'll soon have a successful process or product. To become more resilient, you have to become comfortable with the fact that there'll be failures, and you can do that by treating them as opportunities to learn. Number 4, challenge yourself. It's easy to become comfortable with things, and if you don't do anything, then you'll soon become stagnant. What is the easiest thing to do when something is hard? Obviously, to avoid it, but that will cost you progression and growth. When I started to produce content, the hard thing for me was writing the script. For you, it might be learning how to code or making cold calls. Despite the difficulty, I was putting in the work, and sure enough, I was making progress and improving over time. When you exert effort on any activity or task, there is no doubt that you'll be getting better and better over time. Number 5, change your perspective. It is impossible for you to lose if you refuse to give up. You can't fail unless you decide that you have failed, because failure is in your mind. If you start a business and your product doesn't sell, or your marketing strategy didn't work as planned, then that doesn't mean that you'll never make it. It simply means that you have to create a new product and improve your marketing strategy to keep moving forward. When something is not working, you have to understand that marketplace is giving you feedback that improvements are needed. Number 6, keep learning. What do you do when you hit the obstacle? Sometimes the key is to distract yourself, and you can do that by learning something new. It is already hard to work towards your goals, and the last thing you want to see is the obstacle in your way. Instead of focusing on obstacle, try to leave it and educate yourself around this topic. This way, you have more chances to overcoming it. Number 7, stay optimistic. If you want to increase your chances to succeed, then you have to be optimistic about future outcome that you want to achieve. Starting a business is not a rational decision. It's more like a gamble, as 60% of new businesses fail in the first 3 years. When you set goals that are way outside your reach, it requires you to look at them with an optimistic view. Otherwise, you might as well not try at all. Also, when you're going through tough times, it helps if you can see positive things, as that will keep you going forward. Number 8, incremental improvements. Do you want to make huge progress towards your goals? I do, but I also know that it is a sure way to get disappointed and give up. You're better off aiming for consistent incremental improvements that will in the end deliver the results that you desire. When you're writing a book, focus on writing one good page at a time. If you're building a YouTube channel, then focus on creating one video at a time. If you keep at it for long enough, then you'll definitely achieve the goals that you are working towards. I hope that you enjoyed this resilience book review, and these strategies will keep you going when life will be throwing challenges at you. If you enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate if you could press the like button, as this will help the video reach more people and spread the message.